Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Robin Williams.
Up front, let's have a cigarette, let's relax. We're here in New York, fucking New York. Yes. Obviously, this is not going to be your normal night of theater. This will be Shakespeare with a strap on. So that's the way you like it. Welcome to my lovely set, which is from the musical Fantastic Voyage. Or maybe the last thing a clitoris sees. I'm over here! I'm down here! This is brought to you by HBO, which is a subsidiary of Time Warner, also owned by America Online. You've got mail. I hope you don't have stocks. Now, welcome. Don't be afraid. It was so reassuring the other day. George W. Bush talked to the stock market and... You know, it must be him talking about business ethics. It's kind of like having a leper give you a facial. It doesn't really work. Oopsie. A lot of our imports come from other countries. No shit, Chase. Whoopsie. Moving right along. Meanwhile, Michael is protesting. I don't know, baby. It was strange enough when Michael was the best man at Liza's wedding. That, for me, it was like, you're pushing the term, my man. That was a pretty short list. Who was Richard Simmons hunting? What happened? What were you doing?
I'm the best man.
But now Michael is claiming racism. I'm going, honey, you gotta pick a race first. Mm-mm. Baby! What are you claiming, mistreatment of elves? What are you saying? Girl, you gotta pick a gender too. What are you going for? You were Diana Ross. Now you just left it all behind. Mm-mm. And Michael, you're not a freak. You're just, surgically enhanced. And you've spent more money than the Vatican, so let's not talk right now. Shh. If you go to Neverland, it says you must be this high to ride Michael. Obviously, people in the lawyers for HBO are going, fuck! But how fucked up do you have to be for Al Sharpton to go, I'm out of here, man? Goddamn. Woo! Damn, baby! If Al Sharpton bails on your ass, even rats are going, man, that guy's queer. From the Don King School of Hair Processing. He's running for office in Idaho on the what a fucking wild, crazy chance in hell you'll be elected ticket. Sorry, my lips just went, what the fuck did you say? A couple of dyslexic people went, thank you, Robin. Thank you. We're worried about the Pledge of Allegiance. We were gonna say, one nation under dog. It's okay. I know, people are going, I've got a cure for this. I'm thinking, one nation under Canada, above Mexico. Yes! Yeah, but then you have to do the whole other... There's anthems like, someone bless America. Instead in the dollar bill, instead of in God we trust, in Gates we trust. Mr. Gates, when did you realize you were creating a monopoly? Monopoly's just a game, Senator. I'm trying to control the fucking world. Don't you see, Windows Millennium me? It's all leading to information technology. Soon it'll be total information technology. Tit. And when you're sucking on the tit, I have you by the motherboard. Don't be afraid. But it's a nice day in New York, my people. It's a beautiful day. New York police have a catch and release program. Way to go. Stop! Okay, go on again. You're it. Get the fuck out of here. I like New York on a day like today. I mean, for a while, you know, everything, people were like, are you okay? And now people are back to being New Yorkers like, have a nice day, asshole. Fuck you, my friend. Enjoy your day. But the most beautiful thing about a day like today in this New York is that the ladies take the twins for a walk. Oh, yeah, the titties are out today. On a hot day, all the titties are out there, and they're the titties like God made them, going, honey, me, me. Beautiful titties, all different shapes and sizing, and women running, and they're going, hubbada, hummada, hummada. And then they hit a breeze, and chicken's done. Yes. Yeah, baby. These are not like the tits in Vegas, where even God goes, I didn't make those. Weird tits. You know, fake tits are like Nazis. They don't laugh, they don't dance, they just... I'm walking here. I've seen a woman turn and the tits stay there. Babies, lucky they don't have any teeth because they'd knock them out. God damn. I've seen tits that are really bad, like they had the nipples on the top. It looked like Kilroy. But don't talk to me about the... When you go up Madison Avenue, you see some hardcore surgery, like... I'm so scared, but I can't express it. These are the ladies who've had so much surgery, they're going, what are these lumps under my eyes? Those are your tits, madam. And what's this? Don't ask, Mrs. Trotsky, don't ask. This is good news for you. And girls getting Botox injections, so I... Look, I don't have any wrinkles. You also have no expression. You look like you've had a slight coma, but you're beautiful. All this amazing transformation. When guys say to you, baby, I want you to get your tits done for me, okay? Mm-hmm. Do it for me. Do it for your daddy man. Then you say, okay, daddy man. Then I want you to get your balls done for me, okay? I want you to get those big old Voight basketballs. So when you do the Baywatch thing, it's like, bling. Nothing drives a woman crazy like a big old Easter basket on her bunny. So when you go to the guy, you go to the doctor, girls in bed, bing, da, bing, da, bing, da, bing, da, bing. Payback's a bitch. Go for it, girls. Because you went through a hard time. This whole winter was so bizarre. The temperatures, it was like 80, 20, 30, 50. It was weather by Sybil. It was fucking weird. The weathermen are going, I don't fucking know what's going on. Let's just see what happens. This spring, flowers were like Anne Hesh going, I'm out, I'm in, I'm out. I don't know where to go. Dear God. And God, now, I love it when George came back from Japan. He went, I went to the Coyote Conference. No, it's Kyoto. Oh, it's a very good car. No. George, walk away. And they say there's no global warming, but right now the North Pole is a pool. There's things just floating away, and it is beyond global warming at this point. It is cooking. It's 105 in the middle of the country, and people come up going, is it hot enough for ye? No, I like sweat to be rolling down the crack of my ass like Niagara. I let it just, I like my old man titties to lactate, my man. And you see people in shorts that you're going, please don't wear those. Oh, please don't put those on. And if you go to Southwest Airlines, they're going, I'm sorry, you're not fat, you're horizontally challenged. Big people, and now if you go to Southwest Airlines, you have to buy two seats. The problem is they're not together. Scary. You know, and you have to put your tits in the overhead rack. But people don't mind now. We're working our way through. And all over the country, you got weird things like in Houston. Houston, they got Enron Field. We're going to call it Fifth Amendment Field, but fuck. We can't call it We're Fucked Field. Arthur Anderson put in the chairs. They spin both ways. And now Martha Stewart may become somebody's bitch. No! See, it ain't so! I like to consider it more like severe companion. If you only have one room, and I like to call it my private space, use the light well. You know, you have vertical bars, don't use horizontal blinds. Also, think of your ankle bracelet as an accessory. When it goes off, I just can't wait for her going, the first time she has lunch, going, you call this quiche? Shut up, bitch, you're inside now, you're mine. God damn, baby. All over, things have been going good here. I've been all over. I've been to Memphis, I've been to Graceland, and I never knew that Ray Charles had a decorating license. But there's some severe... There are colors there that have never seen daylight. I've been to Nashville, I've heard people sing songs like, oh, take your finger out of my ass, cause I'm leaving you behind. Funny-ass shit, people do it now. It's a weird thing, and sweating like crazy up here right now, but it's HBO, because it's live. Going on out. And now you got it all going on. People playing baseball, it's good. You got a good season. Yankees are kicking again. Way to go. You know. That's all right. You did a good job. It came through. And everybody's worried about people playing, you know, playing baseball on steroids. I'm going... Really? Well, here's one quick way you tell. Two things happen on steroids. Your balls shrink and your head grows. So if someone steps up to the plate with a Mardi Gras head and raisinettes, you're out! Watch out! Poor Barry Bonds, man, they won't pitch to him, and when they do, they're trying to kill him. He's like, Yasser Arafat of baseball, man. And for Jerusalem right now, I do believe there's a plan. I have a plan. It's an interesting plan. It's called a timeshare, like Miami. Let's try that. Jews will get Hanukkah, Passover, Christians will get Christmas and Easter, and the Muslims will have Ramadan and that other holiday, kaboom. Now, obviously right now the people at HP are going, oh, fuck off! What are you doing, you asshole? But for me, I'm very excited because this is my time when I was watching World Cup soccer, my man. I saw World Cup, baby. No, no. A few soccer fans, the rest of you are going,
oh, that's like football without pads, right?
For the rest of the world, it's football. For us, it's like
a strange sport played by damaged people.
Well, we made it in the World Cup. Everybody plays it. Not like the World Series, because the French don't have a baseball team. If they did, they would only have left field, and no one would be safe. You know what I'm saying? What can you do, huh? It is Bastille Day, hello! Allons-y de la patrie! The day that Marie Antoinette gave the ultimate head. Look out! Ah! We are French. Fuck you, Americans. I don't care. My friend is in right now. My Lance Armstrong is in France, racing in the Tour de France. He is right now. And every year the French go, he is on chemicals. I'm going, it's chemotherapy, you little toad sucker. Okay, he has one testicle. He's aerodynamic. Everybody cut off your balls. You'll be quicker. Do it! Don't be afraid, eh? Because, you know, when you look at the World Cup, America finally made it. We made it to the 16, baby! Woo! Got them right! Lord, yeah! We're no longer in the Special Olympics category. They used to see us coming going, oh, give it to them, they're damaged people.
Thank you for the ball! I got a ball, I shoot the ball!
Unlike the Brazilians, man, when the Brazilians play, it's like bang, bang, dum, bang, 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 bang. And the fans are like, bang, 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 bang. Brazilians going, look, I'm playing soccer, okay? Look, I'm scoring. And now I'm kicking the ball. Because soccer's kind of mellow. You know, it's a little passive aggressive, though, when you got that thing of like, pff, 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 eh, I didn't do anything. What are you looking at? It's not like hockey where someone comes up with a stick and goes, bam, motherfucker! That's why there are no Spanish hockey players, because the first time a white guy takes a stick and goes, bam, motherfucker, I'm going to cut you off now! And you, Freddy Krueger, bitch, take off the mask, motherfucker! Coming in there, goddammit! But like soccer, sometimes guys will do this weird thing. They'll fall down and pretend like, oh shit, I'm fucking, I've been killed, I've been blinded. Oh, there's nobody near me, huh? Okay, I'm kidding. And the referee comes over, yellow card. Two yellow cards, red card. Hold on, three cards, green card. And the referee is so sweet, too. He's kind of like, okay, What's your name? Turn around. What's your fucking name? Why didn't you call me after the Mexico game? Not like, you know, football referees who have that too much commercial time. Bad white men dancing on the field. Moving away. What are we doing? And then it was strange in the World Cup, they always claim this bad refereeing. Someone may have been paid off. Oh, shit, say it ain't so. You're telling me that the Oscars are also political? Oh, fuck off. The mauve hand. Shh. Fairy godfather.
Does this pistol make my ass look big?
Shh. If you go to L.A., there's a great greeting these people do. They come up and go, love you. Love you. Hey, love you. Love you. We were talking briefly about bad refereeing. The worst one, I guess, was in the Winter Olympics with the French judge. Once again, the French fuck with us, huh? The Canadians, they skate perfectly, eh? We did it perfect, huh? And then the Russians, they come, oh, fuck! They fucked up, and the French judge went, how like life, they fucked up. I give it to them, huh? At that point, I'm going, where is Tonya Harding when you need her? Tonya would have been on that judge like shit on Velcro. She'd be going, give me that medal, you French whore!
I won!
But instead, we get to see Tonya fight Paula Jones in an all-white trash weekend. Trailer Park Tuesday! And Tonya went right for Paula, too. She went right for the nose. Not the nose, that's the Clinton money, not the nose. And then next, it's going to be Joy Buttafuoco fights John Wayne Bobbitt. There will be no hitting below the belt there, my friend.
Oh, fuck, man, give it back. My balls are in the front row.
What's next? The Nixon daughters battle for the library money. Be there as my bitches go at it. At this point, even Caligula's going, what the fuck are you people doing? Why did you have Hannibal Lecter on Iron Chef? Just kick out the jams. Because we've got the chamber, the chair, Fear Factor. People in Texas are going, we got those shows. We just don't film them. 2 weeks ago, the Supreme Court banned execution of retarded people, and people in Texas are going, shit, where's the fun now? Because they were zapping retarded people every other week. It was like, go sit on Santa's lap, Timmy. But bam! And I know the definition of retarded in Texas is pretty wide. But, I mean, they're out there, baby. It's crazy. God damn, brother. They throw the shit out there. It's pretty wild, too. You know, even the Taliban is going, you are crazy motherfuckers. There was a guy with one leg. They weren't going to give him a wooden leg. It was going to be dead man hopping. 5, 10, 15, 28. But there is a moment of compassion. Before the lethal injection, they do an alcohol swab, which is so nice. What the fuck are you doing? We don't want you to get that last second infection. Come on now. It's all safe now. But you remember the Winter Olympics? They were so proud. They had them in Utah saying, God, it's a great place. What, was Amish country booked? What happened?
Come on down to Salt Lake. We are going to party like it's 1955. Bring your wives. Oops. Come on down.
And at the closing ceremony, they introduced Donnie and Marie as the first couple of Utah. I went, uh-uh, honey, no. They're only a couple in Arkansas. Ah. And ladies and gentlemen, if you're going to Georgia, I just want to tell you Ted Turner and Jane Fonda broke up. They did. Jane found God, and Ted found out it wasn't him. Now, we're at the Olympics once again. We're talking about the figure skating, where the judge did all the controversy. But I find the figure skating to be kind of sexy. Yeah, baby, you know, not ice dancing, which is polka on Valium. That's not good. But there's that pairs figure skating, and there's that one very special lift where the male figure skater goes, whoo, right here. Or even a gynecologist would go, put on a glove, man. It's that, who's your daddy, who's your daddy, who's your daddy? Yes! And I'm going, let's cut the foreplay, let's have ice fucking, come on. Whoa, what? Oh, hey. Oh, oh, yes. Oh, nipples around and... And she holds on without her hands. Oh! Oh! Even the French judge would go, I like it. I don't care. I'm giving them the medal. Fuck the Canadian. So fabulous. And there's other kind of sexual things in the Olympics. There's the luge, which I have only one question. What drunken German gynecologist invented that sport? What guy went, you know what? I want to dress like a sperm, shove an ice skate in my ass, and go balls first down an ice chute. Yeah. That will be fun. No, this is for pussies. How will you steer? I will do kegels. I will flex my ass and go down the run. Yeah. And do not talk to me about the two-man luge. I'm saying, boys, get a room. Come on. Gonna, oh, make that turn, you bastard. Make it. Hard right, you fucker, hard right. Poor guy gets to the end of the run going, I got wood, man, I'm sorry. Well, you cost us the race. Your penis going was 2/100ths of a second wind's resistance. We could have won if you weren't going bring, dolphin boy. Yes. Ah, and there's always some horrible drug scandal as in the Olympics. This year was a Spanish cross-country skier, which is like a skier. Are you a skeeler?
Yes.
He was going down there, and he basically, they accused him of taking, some performance-enhancing drug, like an elephant growth hormone or something. Are you on some sort of drug? Are you taking an animal tranquilizer? Oh, no. And they didn't bother drug testing the snowboarders. They just, oh, get the fuck out. Go on. Go, go, my little boys. Have fun. I guess they realized the word half-pipe meant something. Aye, because it was a very strange thing. Remember the kid who won the gold medal? He was in freestyle, and they said, do you want to be in a box of Wheaties? He went, no. Count Chocula. Aha, a clue, Sherlock. Unlike the poor Canadian snowboarder in 1998 Olympics, they took away his medal because he tested positive for marijuana, which is kind of redundant, number one. Number two, they said that marijuana was a performance-enhancing drug. Marijuana enhances many things, colors, tastes, sensations, but you are certainly not fucking empowered. When you're stoned, you're lucky if you can find your own goddamn feet. The only way it's a performance-enhancing drug is if there's a big fucking Hershey bar at the end of the run. Oh, yeah. And then you'll be like... You'll be like a Swiss ski jumper going, I'm there! Poor Canadian snowboarder, they asked for his medal back and he couldn't find it. It was around his fucking neck. Get out of here, you little goofy Canadian bastard, eh? Then they have weird sports like the biathlon, which is like, he's like Norwegian drive-by. Get the TV, Hunt! Swayze. And, well, the Canadians, they won the gold medal in hockey, and I went, come on, man, it's... Yay, all right, hey! God bless you, Canadian people. You're so fucking nice, eh? It's your only fucking sport, come on. That and a mutant form of football. We've got 13 men, we have a longer field. No, you have fun, enjoy. Yes, we are the Canadians. Canada is like a loft apartment over a really great party, you know? They're like, keep it down, eh?
They're all up there going, yeah, we are nice. We have Jean Chrétien, a great prime minister, huh? And we have that. He's right there. He was the only man in the world. I don't need no Secret Service. A guy comes to hit me, I fucking knock him out, eh? I'm Jean Chrétien, which versus your president, who is a Chrétien. But I don't care. But for me, you know, Quebec keeps wanting to break away from Canada but still keep the currency. What about that? That's like a kid moving out of the house, but I still would like to get money. Fuck off, you. What are you doing? Canadian money is also called the loonie. How can you take an economic crisis seriously? The loonie is down. Oh, how sad for you. What are you saying, huh? But everyone was so happy that the Olympics, the security was so tight. They were like, security was amazing at the Olympics. I went, yeah, Utah's the whitest fucking state in the union. An Arab in Utah is like an albino at the Apollo. You would notice. It's like going, we found one! Uh-oh, he's just tan. Everybody off. Come on now. And the problem was there was basically white powder everywhere, so all the dogs looking for anthrax are going, oh, shit! You go, man, you go! Poor dogs, they look for anthrax and cocaine. They go back to their cage at the end of the day going, I can't taste my ass. I don't know why. Oh, it's my tail. Meanwhile, your cat sits over there going, you're still an asshole, you know that. Is it me or are cats drag queens? I think they are. The way they kind of go, who loves kitty? You love kitty? Are these your shoes? Who loves kitty? Who loves kitty? And the way they have that whole thing too, male cats have that amazing thing where they're kind of walking around going, that's mine. Mine? I like that too. Thank God men aren't like that. Hey, nice car, Bob. Mine now. What are you doing? Oh, just shopping. Back off. Yeah, baby. But the whole anthrax thing had people going, though. Remember, they said, don't open your mail. Why? There's white powder in envelopes. Really? Your mother and I used to look for white powder in envelopes. We weren't online, we did lines, my friend. Yes, oh yeah, and there were ninjas on the fucking lawn trying to kill us. And now there are people trying to kill us. And that's why I bought a gas mask. I thought, I'll be safe, I've got a gas mask. I went, wait a minute, I can't even get a condom on when I want to. You know that thing where you're going, hey baby, yeah, I got a love glove, yeah. Hold on, yeah. I'll be right with you, honey. God, don't go away on me now, man. You're playing beat the cock. Come on, damn it. I got it. And there's your penis like a midget in a diving suit. I don't think we're going in today, Pete. We didn't make the deadline. Oh, yeah, baby. It's out. And do you remember when they sent anthrax to Congress? They did. They sent it to Tom Daschle's office, and they cleared that fucking place out. It was like, everybody out! Come on! Hazmat suits, they're all leaving. They're putting them underground. They're protecting them. But as the congressmen walk out, they go, but the rest of you, go about your lives. Everything is perfectly okay. We'll be miles away. It's like when you go to the dentist and he puts a little lead bib over your balls. He walks behind concrete going, you'll be fine. But how can you tell if Congress was sick? It's Night of the Living Dead anyway. They're all over there. All those old senators like Strom and Jesse going, you know the Confederate flag is just a symbol of states' rights. Yeah, and a swastika is just a Tibetan good luck charm. Now, come on. Come on out of here. There. It's scary. Now, I have one thing. When did Ted Kennedy become Jabba the Hutt? He's huge! You're a Kennedy, not a Macy's Day float. Come on! Bring him down, we're voting! Step away, boy! I said no to the Krispy Kreme. Yes! And Congress recently approved the covert plan
to assassinate Saddam Hussein. So what they've done is publicly approve the secret plan to assassinate Hussein. I wonder if he knows. But I do know. I know this one thing. I know there's a cure for whatever bioterrorism that they send at us. I know there's one, and it lies within Keith Richards. I know that. He's the only man on the planet who can go, anthrax. All right. Hey, doesn't go with my E. coli, but fuck. Keith is the only man who can make the Osbournes look fucking Amish. He's insane. I've seen Keith go to a drug dealer and drug dealer's going, I'm out, man. I'm sorry. I have nothing left. Supposedly, he goes to Switzerland and changes his blood. Not like one pint, but like a fucking Chevrolet. All of it. I just want to know who gets his blood. Some old Swiss man's going, Heidi! We've got to go on tour, you bitch! We've got to pay for mixed babies! Come on! Because I know this. I know that we may all be dead and gone. Keith will still be there with 5 cockroaches. Keith will go, you know, I smoked your uncle. Did you know that? Fucking crazy. Because this is what's happening, ladies and gentlemen. Every so often, Rumsfeld comes out and goes, I don't know where. I don't know when. But something awful is going to happen. Thank you. That's all for today. No further questions. Oh, excuse me, can you give me a clue? What is it, the Central Intuitive Agency now? Are you working with Miss Cleo? Maybe. I don't know where, I don't know when, but something awful is going to happen. And definitely don't marry that fat man, he only wants you for your money, girl. People are suing Miss Cleo for fraud. I went, fucking duh. What do you want? What do you want, a blind tarot card before you go, aha? First of all, if she's a psychic, why does she need a fucking phone number? Number one. Number two, that fake that Jamaican accent going, oh, I don't know it. Like, if she was a real psychic, she'd be like those Louisiana psychics going, you're gonna die. You're gonna have to park your ass up so I can pull a place for your bike. Come on now. I'm saying it's like buying hair care products from Cher. She's wearing a wig, you idiot. Here's what you have to do. You have to take that little abdominal thing that helps you lose weight while it shocks your fat ass sitting watching TV. I'm getting 6-pack abs by knocking my testicles around. No, what you do is you strap that to your head and say, I will not buy stupid shit for no reason. There you go. Come on, baby. Here's the drill. Because now, man, we are in troubled times, you know. When it initially happened, I thought the Statue of Liberty would change. Instead of, give me your tired, your poor, be here with a baseball bat going, you want a piece of me? Because when it happened, there was hardcore security. New York, you had hardcore security stopping people on the way in the tunnels. In Washington, they'd have F-18s flying air cover everywhere. In San Francisco, not so hardcore security. Golden Gate Bridge, at one end, there's a Hummer, and I'm talking about the car. People going, really? Now, what? One Hummer here, 2 National Guardsmen. At the other end of the bridge, another Hummer, 2 National Guardsmen. Problem is, the Hummer and the National Guardsmen are in jungle camouflage. For those of you who've never been to San Francisco, the bridge is bright orange. So I feel like going, be very, very quiet. We're looking for terrorists. No. And... what? Airport security. Remember before all this happened, it was like, oh, beep. Okay, get on the plane. Come on, get on the plane. Hold on one moment. What's that? Oh, that's a gun. Okay, get on the plane. You could carry a 4-inch blade on a plane. That's about that long. Now, you can't even carry a nail clipper on a plane. Are they afraid you're going to go, all right, give me the plane or the bitch loses a cuticle. I've got a nail file. I can be irritating. And if you have a steak or any piece of meat, they don't give you a knife. So it's like Quest for Fireflight. Like, ha ha! Ha ha! Sir, you're making a lot of noise. The Hindu man in the back is going, hold the bowl higher, hold it higher. Don't be afraid to beg. Use your hands. Because now when you go through airport security, that's tight. You go through the metal detector, and if you're heavily pierced, like some of my friends, it's like, eh. Take out your keys, sir. Tip of the iceberg. For those playing the home game, this is called a Prince Albert. And I'm sure that was his last wish. I'm sure Albert said, Victoria, I'm dying. I want you to name a museum, a performance hall, and a boat through the cock after me. That will be Victoria's Secret. Go, my darling. Sell little thongs to people like that and little anal floss. Go, 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 my dear. And I'm talking pierced, though, heavily pierced, not like Britney Spears. I'm a virgin, yeah, and Michael Jackson's a father. Move on. Now, I'm talking like a hoop through your nipple. You know, lady, you get the... I'm guessing. Whoopsie! Just a kind of... The way your clothes were kind of going... You know, when you have a big hoop for your nipple, you're going, what are you going to do? Tie up a pony? No. Or you have two hoops through the nipples. You go, his and her towels, his and hers, whatever you want. A towel down here so you can wash up. Fun! But the most interesting thing is when you see a girl with a bolt through her tongue. And I went, why did you do that? To enhance the sexual stimulation. Nothing drives my boyfriend crazy like the feel of cold steel on his hot rod. But the problem is I end up knocking out all my teeth and living in a trailer park with a man named Bubba. That's the trade-off, my darling. You know, you get the tattoo of the barbed wire now when you're 18, and by the time you're 80, it's fucking picket fence. And Madonna, you get it now, and by the time you're 80, she turns into Margaret Hamilton going, oh, I'm dead! Music! Here's what you want to do. Here's some fun stuff. When I was growing up, I didn't have Playboy or Penthouse. Sad for me. But I had National Geographic, and the girls that got me crazy. Oh, yeah. You know, the ones with the slinky neck going, back, I'm in the back of my neck. Do that. Drive your parents crazy when you come down the stairs going, I'm in the back of my neck. Or do the full you bangy go, Mom, Dad, it's also a CD player. And you could take out the plate and jump rope with your lower lip. Have fun. Watch Grandma go, shit. Because, oh, Union guy's going, don't touch it, Mr. Williams. This shit is going to be more precious than oil. This is the stuff. 10 years from now, it's already starting to happen. People will be going, psst, yo, I got water. And if you want a coal, I got ice, motherfucker. Now, when you're going on the planes now, you always have this strange thing that comes out, this sweet little southern stewardess usually comes out and goes, ladies and gentlemen, before we board flight 5, we're just going to do a few random bag checks. These are totally random. I'm just going to read off a few names. Hassan bin Singh. Akeem bin Laid. Haven bin Fucked. Judy Smith. 14 Arabs and a blonde. And every black man and every Hispanic man in the room is going, thank you, God. Oh, Lord, yes, we're off the list, motherfucker, yeah. Yeah, indeed. The man's going to be fucking with you now, Habib. You better learn to go orderly. And sure, they try and mix it up. They take the knitting needles away from the 85-year-old lady. Why? Because I'm going to knit an Afghan? Give them to me. And the 5-year-old kid, they're patting him down. He's going, what are you doing? You're not a priest. Let go of me. Oh. I see. So you've had a problem too, I guess. Father Pat's little private pat and chat's like, good game, boy, good game, good game. Wash up, Timmy, really wash up. It's amazing they would catch them, and it wasn't just enough to catch them, but they had the Divine Witness Protection Program. You know, find the priest, here's the pedophile, here's the priest, find the pedophile, find the priest, find the pedophile, there, move them around. Here we come, we're going to say to me again. Don't you ask, then become a tool. Here we go. Don't you ask, don't you tell, you might end up right in hell. Here we go, here we go. Here's your check, direct from Rome, buy yourself a brand new home, moving around, moving around. Wasn't that amazing? The Pope. From this.
Applause break number two. But it was amazing when the Pope gathered all the cardinals in Rome and went, "Sheesh!" The only problem is he's dressed like Liberace's stunt double. Whoops! I have a solution, though. For problem priests, little thing of shock collar, if they go near a kid, it's like, "You know, Timmy, oh! Tommy, I think, oh!" Or the automated confessional, could be fun. "If this is a venial sin, press one. If this is a carnal sin, press two. If this is cardinal law, please stay on the line." Because you have to remember, it's not just a sin, it's a felony. So we have to keep track. Now, you have one other thing. We now know, right now, that's up there, they're watching. "Hi, Mr. Ashcroft." But we are now under the offices of Homeland Security. Tom Ridge will come out every so often and go, "Today's a blue day." No, orange. Red. And they had to be very careful picking that name, Homeland Security. You couldn't say Fatherland because a lot of old Germans are going, "That's a good one." But Homeland Security, it sounds like Home Front Security, which was England during World War II. Old men with pitchforks and colostomy bags defending England. There they were. I captured Rudolf Hess personally. I threw my colostomy bag, covered him in shite, and said, "Get out of that fucker, you fucker. Get out." There I did. And I also find out now that Winston Churchill, one of the greatest orators of all time, may have been so fucked up on cognac and champagne that he didn't do some of his great speeches. They were done by a man from the BBC who also did Winnie the Pooh. "We will fight them on the beaches, in the air, on the land. Eeyore and Tigger." And he was fighting against Hitler, a man who recently a book declared was a homosexual, and I always thought this was a clue. That and the leather and the dancing. But we are now finding ourselves once again drawn to England during these troubled times. Tony Blair, a militant liberal. Over here, George W. Bush, compassionate conservative. I don't know what that is. Sounds kind of like a Volvo with a gun rack. But over here, Tony Blair, a man who must address the House of Commons, which is like Congress with a two-drink minimum. Crazy place. "I believe my worthy opponents..." Oh, fuck off! "Shite! Bullocks, you bastard! Fuck you! Will someone remove Mrs. Thatcher from the chamber?" There she goes. But it was Tony who said, "This heinous incident has brought us to the edge of oblivion, but our civilization shall endure." And there's poor W going, "Shit, I can't even spell that." Damn! Because you look at Bush and you realize it's Bush 2.0, okay? It's a beta release. He came with certain bugs in the software, all right? He'll go, "This country will not be taken hostile." Oops, delete, delete, hostage, okay. And then you look at him and you realize he does have a short attention span. He'll be going, "Our economy is growing." Oh, look at the kitty. But he kind of reminds me of the guy in college with a towel going, "Gotcha." But you just don't want him to drive. Oh, but you realize some men are born great, some achieve greatness, some get it as a graduation gift. That's okay. Historically, you must look at it from a historical perspective, though. He's George II, the boy king, a man we thought could only lose, but somehow won because of confused Hebrews. Yes, it is that. And notice this, my friends. W doesn't speak while Cheney's drinking water. Check that shit out. That's why, baby. When everything went down, they put W out there, but they protected Cheney. Remember that? Cheney who had angioplasty. Most people wait till it kind of heals. He was like, "I'm perfectly fine. I'm okay." And there's Ashcroft in the back going, "Work the arms, you asshole, work the arms." Folks, you have to remember, here's the drill. You have to remember, John Ashcroft is a man who lost to a dead man in Missouri. Can't forget that. Choices in Missouri were John Ashcroft, dead man. And people in Missouri went, I'm sorry, John, the dead man scares me less than you do. So, gotta know it. And Here's the drill for me. You know, it's strange, but I know this. It doesn't scare me that W waved at Stevie Wonder. That's okay. That's okay. Stevie's only been blind since birth. And there's W going, Stevie! Even Stevie Wonder's going, is that motherfucker waving at me? Right there! Does he think I'm looking for him? Goddamn! No. What scares me is that W almost died from a fucking pretzel. We have billions of dollars in national defense. They want billions more for national security to up the stakes. And he almost fucking goes down from snack food. Secret Service are going, game's over, man!
Gilligan's down. Gilligan's down.
Step away from the chips, sir! Do we have to have people go, hydrate, you bastard, hydrate? His own dogs didn't give a shit. They were licking him for the salt. What is it, boy? You need a dog that cares. A dog like Lassie who would go, woo, woo. Woo, woo. What's wrong, Lassie? President swallowed something and you did the Heimlich? Woo, woo. What else, girl? Mr. Cheney's meeting with the Enron people? An Enron employee, Secretary of the Navy? What about the Harkin loan?
Sorry, girl, we're gonna have to put you down.
Oh, Kenny boy, the feds are coming. Welcome, boys and girls, to Disney's new ride, Investment Pirates of the Caribbean. Your money checks in, it doesn't check out.
But we have to know this, my friends, you know this. Sometimes you catch George unprepared. He says unusual things. Like the first day, they said, Mr. Bush, what are we going to do? He said, well, we're going to go after these folks and conduct a crusade. And everybody in the room went, ooh.
Ixnay on the Ukraine say. All throughout the Middle East, Allah Faglan! Shalom Akhalafilan! Hide the women and children in the number zero. They're coming!
And you can't bomb the Afghanis back to the Stone Age because they'll go, upgrade, fuck.
Now, today's bombing raid has enlarged the hole from yesterday's bombing raid. We have moved rubble from here to here. Goat in the upper right-hand corner, possible member of the Taliban or concubine, we are not sure. We did fire the $100 million cruise missile up its ass and we're successful. Operation Extreme Redundancy is carrying on. Now, then we started to drop bombs. Food bombs. And here's the fun part. Some of the bombs were little yellow bombs, and the food packages were little yellow packages. So now you're playing Survivor the real game. It's like,
okay, Bob, I was here yesterday. I'm going to go for this one today.
And what was in those packages? Pop-Tarts, peanut butter, and all you need is a honey-baked ham, and you got a redneck Christmas. But who dropped the honey-baked ham on the Muslim pipeline? Shh, idiot. Now, why are we dropping Pop-Tarts and peanut butter on Afghanistan? Number one, tastes a shitload better than dirt. Yes. Number two, and more importantly, very difficult to have a call to jihad with a mouthful of peanut butter. Secondly, or thirdly, for those keeping track, Afghanistan is a hashish-smoking culture. And anyone who's ever been a friend of the hookah will go, Pop-Tarts. Yes! Got milk? Come against me! Because what are we trying to do? We're trying to win hearts and minds. How do we do that? Do we build a big amusement park called Muslim Mountain with Gaddafi Duck? No. Do we have a wet burqa contest? No. Do we play Cat Stevens records all day? Fuck off. Drop Martha Stewart tapes? No. Do we have a children's show called Saudi Duty? No. What we must do is go the Greek way, the Lysistrata way. You gotta get a sister, you know what I'm saying? And you gotta get a sister from Brooklyn. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Uh-huh, girl. You know what I'm saying? One of those bitches you see on Jerry Springer going, mm-mm-mm. Drop her ass in Kabul and she'll go, girl, You don't have to dress like a motherfucking beekeeper. Forget that. Mm-mm. You don't have to be Casper's bitch. Forget all that. Take off that hefty bag, girl. Mm-mm. And if he picks up a rock because you're talking to another man, you pick up a bigger rock and say, Shiite has hit the fan, motherfucker. Mm-mm. He tries to cut off your clitoris, make you a Barbie doll, you grab a knife and say, Lorena Bobbitt time. Don't make me go Cobra. I will go Oprah on your ass. Don't make me. Mm-mm. Because what are we dealing with? We're dealing with fundamentalists. The Amish are fundamentalists, but they don't try and hijack a carriage at needlepoint. Now. And if you're ever in Amish country and see a man with his arm buried in a horse's ass, that's a mechanic. Remember that. Well, who are we looking for? We are looking for Osama bin Laden, one of 52 children. Even Freud would say he has issues. What does he look like without the beard? Howard Stern, Barbara Streisand? I don't know. I don't care. I know this. He is a 6'5" Arab on dialysis. Why is that so fucking hard to find? It's like, oh, la, 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 la. Look for somebody attached to their luggage. Be, dee, be, dee, be. Try this. I also know one thing. When you see the tapes of him, you see a psychopath very calmly talking about horrible things. And went, wait a minute, we have some of our own. Theodore Kaczynski sitting around with nothing to do. Ted's played a beautiful mind the home game. You give Ted a mailing list and some tools. You say, Ted, these people have been bad. He goes, are they bad? Oh, very bad. I just want a few things. Oh, I know you do. Here you go. Or maybe we get Charles Manson, great organizer, incredible with chicks, but no, you can't use him. Because Chucky all the time comes up for parole and he's gouged a swastika in his forehead. I'm better in many ways, yeah. Charles, what would you do if you got out? I'd kill everybody! Whoopsie! Because what are we dealing with? One of the fundamental things is in a jihad. That sounds like a country western term like jihad! But if in a jihad you kill an infidel, which I am said to say is all of us, and you yourself die, you go to heaven and you are greeted by 71 dark-haired virgins. Now, anyone who's ever been with one virgin's going, I don't know.
For my talent portion, no, no, no. No, no, no.
And recently, there was an article in the New York Times, the Quran scholar said, the actual translation is not 71 dark-haired virgins, but 71 crystal-clear raisins. Slight difference in interpretation, really? That's very strange. It's like finding out thou shalt not kill is thou shalt not wear a kilt. And the Scottish are going, fuck off! No! And imagine some guy blows himself up, goes to the gates of heaven saying, where are my bitches? Here are your raisins. Or 71 Virgils going,
you got a pretty mouth.
Well, one day we get Osama bin Laden, he goes to the gates of heaven. There's George Washington waiting, going, how dare you defile that which we created? And starts wailing on his ass. 70 other members of the Continental Congress come down and start kicking the shit out of him. And then he's going, what is this? Where are the virgins? 71 Virginians, you asshole. Beloved, salam! I must talk to Jesus Christ. Where is Jesus Christ? And St. Peter goes, hey, Jesus, did you call a cab? Come here. Aha! Yes! I heard it! Finally, the PC. We crossed the politically correct line. It was okay to beat the shit out of him, but don't do the ethnic joke. How Buddhist of you. Yes. Remember when they destroyed the two Buddhas? What would Buddha do? Nothing. What does the Buddhist terrorist do? Goes in the middle of the street, takes the gas, self-barbecue. People killing each other in the name of God are going, the fuck are you doing? Making you deal with your shit. Because I don't understand the whole fundamentalist thing. You see, I'm an Episcopal, that's Catholic light. It's kind of like same religion, half the guilt. It's frightening. You know, Catholics have confession, Episcopals have Thanksgiving, your dad has a couple of gin and tonics. I never loved your mother, you know that, don't you? No, I didn't, Dad, and she's right there. Tell her again. Because you have to realize, Episcopal is basically Church of England, which was Henry VIII breaking away from the Catholic Church going, I'm the fucking Pope now, ha, ha, ha. He broke away, and then people broke away from that church. There were Calvinists. They found him to be too loose. And then there were the people who broke away from the Calvinists. There were the Puritans, our ancestors. People so uptight, the English kicked them out. How fucking anal do you have to be for the English to go, get the fuck out? No, take your pimp shoes and go. And they land here in America going, hello, we bring you guilt, syphilis, and alcohol. I hope you don't mind. Here, chief, try this. And once you've drunk it, just keep moving till your feathers float. There you go. And the Indians go, oh, but we have a gift for you. For us, it's a sacred herb. But for you, it'll be an addictive carcinogen. I hope you enjoy it.
Tobacco is a lot of fun. And a good cash crop in the end.
Seven. Welcome to Custer's, a casino that cares. This is my wife, sits with a full house. It is now time for the white man to get drunk, and we will get back the land you took from us. Thank you. And here's the thing. All those people, the Puritans, they stayed here, and then their groups broke away from them. And then you get the people that really become severe, and the people who knock on your door at 6:30 in the morning on Sunday going, have you found Jesus? And you just want to come to the door nude and go, no, help me look for him. Come on. Yeah. You get people like Pat Robertson and Jerry Falwell said, this was brought upon us by our sinful ways. I want to put him on a plane, take him over to the Ayatollah and have worldwide fundamentalist wrestling. One time only, a life after death match for all of our souls. Let's get ready to humble. Because here's the drill. Fundamentalists take it to be the word, not translatable, not metaphorical, the word. In the beginning, Genesis, let there be light. Could that be a metaphor for the Big Bang?
No, God just went click.
So you're saying we're all descended from Adam and Eve, then we're all cousins.
That's right. Ding, 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 ding.
Here's the thing. There are miracles, though. There's miracles in the Bible. Like when Moses, and I'm not talking guns and Moses. No, I'm not talking. Not Charlton Heston going, let the Jews go or the Pharaoh gets two in the head. No. Charlton Heston, a man who said guns don't kill people. Apes with guns kill people. No, Chucky, no. Second Amendment, it started off, it was muzzle loaders. People going like this, and this still continues. That's okay. But I'm talking about the time Moses said to Pharaoh, let my people go, and Pharaoh went, in your dreams. And Moses called to God going, God, I need some help. And frogs fell from the sky. Maybe they fell from the sky, or maybe there were Jews with catapults going, now. And thank God it was the Egyptians and not the French, because the French would go, lunch, okay? Why should we let you go, you great caterers? I can't let you go, you crazy people, huh? But frogs fell from the sky. At that point, I'd be going, get your shit and out. Frogs, I said, wait a minute. That's what we should do. That's what we should drop on Afghanistan. Not bombs, not food. Fucking frogs. Frogs, lizards, hamsters, gerbils, shit they haven't seen. And if you want to get people out of caves, a shitload of New York rats. Oh, baby. You know. New York rats will be going, hey, come on, raid. I eat pussy literally. Bring it on! But that's what they dropped in. And even then, Pharaoh was not plussed. He was, oh, please, David Copperfield, no. And then boils, and then firstborn dies. That's it! Hebrews, get out! And everybody, banish, tadanoi, everybody! Hello, let's not wait for the bread to rise. Just take the crackers and the skin off your penis. We're leaving. Excuse me? Why the skin off a penis? We're traveling people. You don't want sand in there. Let's go! And this is so passe. The dicky thing, forget it. Let's move! We're going through the desert, and then they get the Ten Commandments, would be adjusted by certain presidents. That happens later. And they get to the Red Sea there, the sea. And they go, what now, Mr. Magic? What do we do now? We're going to walk on the frogs' backs, with the frogs' backs. Frogs' backs. Thank you for watching me this far. Obviously, I did inhale. So, what will we do now, Mr. Big Shot? And he calls to God again, and the sea parts. And even the most doubting Jew is going, you're good. Let's go, everybody. Come on, everybody. Let's move. Don't eat the shellfish. I'll tell you why later. Let's go. Where are we going?
to Jerusalem to start years of struggle and later to Miami to fuck up an election. Let's go! Allah Hashemen! And then the Pharaoh comes, but the sea closes, and he calls to his cat-like God, but his cat-like God can't do shit because it's afraid of water. And then there's another miracle. The night that Mary said to Joe, Joe, I'm pregnant. And Joe went, Holy Mother of God. And she went, You're right. Oh, Jesus Christ. What a great name, Joe. That is so much better than Shmuel. Way to go. I love you, Joe. Wait, hold on a minute, Mary. Hold on a minute. So I'm the stepfather of God's kid? Yeah. So I can't discipline him. I can't go, you've done wrong, because the kid will look at me and say, you're not my real dad. What are you doing, Mary? How did it happen? Oh, it's immaculate, Joe. Oh, it better be, Mary. It better be immaculate. I'm sorry, I'm transforming Joe into Ralph Cramden. But it seemed to be kind of appropriate because up to that point, all the names in the Bible are very Jewish. You have Noah, Moses, Zebedee, and then you get Mary and Joe. We are just a hyphen it away from Mary Jean and Joe Bob. We could have had Jim Bob, the son of God. Praise to him, Jim Bob. He who finds a stuff and gets me a job. Jim Bob. And here's the other drill. Jesus was an only child because, thank God, who would want to be Jerry, the brother of Christ? That's a tough gig. Come on, Jerry, we're going to the beach. Oh, great, Mom. Yeah, Jesus is going to walk on the water, feed everybody, heal him, and get a whole bunch of disciples. I'll sit there with a rash and sand in my ass. Great day for me. He ends up in a bar at the age of 30 going, yeah, I'm Jerry Christ. Whoop-de-doo. Yeah, I healed somebody. Here, Spot. Come on, boy, heal. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, my brother. Yeah, Jesus, he's a carpenter. I'm a plumber. You do the math. And people say to me, they say, Jesus wasn't Jewish. I say, of course he was Jewish. 30 years old, single, living at home with his parents? Come on. Working in his father's business, his mother thought he was God's gift. He's Jewish. Give it up. It's an old tradition. And if he was Jewish and many of his disciples were Jewish, for the Last Supper, would they have not have gone out for Chinese? I think so. Welcome to Yahweh. Hold on. One moment. No service, no sandal. Okay, you come in now. Hold on, you had 12. All I got is 2 tables of 6 right now. They're not together. Wait a minute, hold on. I got 1 big table by the window, but you all have to face this way. All right. Hold on. You are glowing, so I guess we won't need the lamp. That's very nice. And you just turned a Sichuan chicken into a live chicken. You're very good. And it said that night that Jesus turned to his disciples and said, one of you shall betray me. And Peter said, is it me, Jesus? And Jesus said, no, it is not you, Peter. And Simon said, is it me, Jesus? And Jesus turned to Simon and said, no, it is not you, Simon. And Judas said, is it me, Jesus? And Jesus turned to him and went,
is it me, Jesus?
Thus you see two traditions beginning, Jewish sarcasm and Gentile humor, together, born at that main moment. And the next day, the miracle occurred. Crucifixion, resurrection, and he rose again from the dead. And if he sees his shadow, another 2,000 years of guilt. Yes. And here's for me the one big question. How do you get crucifixion, resurrection, and then chocolate bunnies, colored eggs? How do you do that one? Even kids are going,
rabbits don't lay eggs. What is this?
And you don't want a kid biting the head off a chocolate Jesus. That's not good. You don't want a little cream-filled cross going, no, you don't want that. And you don't want to be putting raspberry jam in the grass going, we're looking for Jesus, kids, come on. Because what are we trying to do? You're trying to keep them involved. That's why we have the saints that did all those amazing things to keep you. Oh, when those saints, they're all there to keep your action up. And then we're starting to lose them. Like St. Christopher. Chris, sorry, babe, dashboard sales are down. The medals aren't selling very well. Drop the kid off your back. Pick up your stuff. You're out of here, baby. Thank you. We're going to have St. Prada, Our Lady of Accessories. Come on. But I want a saint like Mother Teresa. Oh, she's the one who said you can do no great things, only small things with great love. And Pat Robertson said she's not a real Christian. Why, Pat? Because she doesn't have a tax shelter and a university? Give it up, baby.
Mother Teresa never had a line of product. She never had her own perfume. Compassion by Mother Teresa.
I smell because I care.
Compassion.
Gandhi never had Gandhi jeans. Whether you're simply not eating or telling the English to get the fuck out, Gandhi jeans. They come in size one and below.
Because Gandhi was an amazing man. They asked Gandhi, what do you think of Western civilization? He said, I think it would be a wonderful idea. But I know, as beatific as Gandhi was, there was somebody in a Bombay bar going, I know Gandhi. He was a prick. I saw him sucking on a pork hot dog, hitting on Mother Teresa. He kept saying, who's your diaper daddy? Who's your diaper daddy? I saw that with my eye, I saw that. And if you don't believe me, I'd bitch slap you like Shiva. I can do that. Don't press this, don't fucking do that. Don't go ding dong, you asshole. Because India has the atomic bomb, my friend. I could turn this whole place into chicken tikka. India has the bomb, Pakistan has the bomb, and we are prepared to fight over Kashmir, and your fucking president probably thought it was a sweater. What an asshole. I tell you this, India detonated 7 underground nuclear tests, Pakistan detonated 7 underground nuclear tests, and your spy satellites were like Ray Charles in the Louvre. They didn't have a fucking clue. This is what I'm telling you. India has the bomb, Pakistan has the bomb, China has the bomb, or maybe not, maybe they just have 1 billion people go boom.
Russia has the bomb. We have many bombs. We don't know where they all are. Maybe you want a dirty bomb.
And the French have a bomb too. Maybe they have the Michelin bomb. Only destroys restaurants under 4 stars. And they still test their bombs. They're one of the few people who still detonate their bombs. The underground test, where do they do it? In the Sahara, in the total wasteland. No, fuck off. In Tahiti, in paradise. Why? Because we're French. Oh, look, a Greenpeace boat's coming to protest. Fuck off, I sink you. I'm a badass motherfucker, am I not? Look, I'm giving a cigarette to a baby. Do it. Suck on the cigarette, my darling. Life is shit. Get to know this. Oh, you Americans. Oh, done for the baby. Fuck all of you Americans. Ooh, Americans with your politically correct Americans. Fuck all of you. You cultureless, crass Americans. We hate all of you. Oh, fuck all. The Germans are here. Hello, Americans. I love you. Come on, American. Hello. Welcome back, Americans! No, come, you can build a Disneyland near Paris. We won't go, but build it. And we'll have a Minnie Mouse with armpit hair. It'll be great. Smoking a Galois going, I never loved Mickey, you know that. What, he has 3 fingers. What am I, a bowling ball? Fuck off. Don't love him. You're a crass rat-like bastard, I don't care. But there is one country that watches out for all of us. The Swiss, yeah. The Geneva Convention. If there is ever a nuclear war, they will be the only people going,
what was that noise?
In their big hollowed out country with their chocolate and their watches, yeah. The nice Germans, yeah. Or as they like to say, the other white race. Now, I have only one question. How can you trust an army? How butch is an army that has a wine opener on its knife?
Many of you men have never opened Chardonnay under fire. First of all, you take out the wine till you pull out the cork, smell it, say meat or fish, and throw. I don't know, but I've been told Chardonnay must be served cold. Yeah!
Oh, but my God, where did all this impressionistic art come from? And all this jewelry from 1939 to 1945. Fairies must have brought it during the night. Suddenly I have to do the Waldheimlich and cough up an account number. For God. I know there's one thing. I know there is one country that is not developing some horrible weapon of destruction that does not have a secret weapons lab up in the mountains. Jamaica. Irie man, Jamaica would never make an atomic bomb. They may make an atomic bomb.
But I'd rather fight a war with the atomic bomb, because when the atomic bomb goes off, there's devastation and radiation. When the atomic bomb goes off, there's celebration. I look at an eye, and I see an eye, coming away from Rastafari. I rewelcome it, because Rastafari smokes this belief for the communion. If you don't see Jesus, then you never will, ma. I tell you, Nico, what is it? Because I met this one thing, man. I know only one thing. I never met me, an angry pot smoker. I never met a man who's going, hey, you fucking prick! Yeah, get! Yeah! Do. Oh, hold me, you piece of shit. Get over here. Because you see, marijuana. I know this one. Wait a minute. Oh. Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. If you smoke a lot of pot, you may never become a rocket scientist. Or maybe. If you've seen some of the things that have happened recently with NASA, maybe you can. Okay, here's a fuck. Oh, fuck. Okay, the Mars lander, okay? Fuck. I did the calculations in feet, but I programmed the lander in meters. Oops. So instead of landing, fucker buried $185 million, whoopsie. 2 years, splat. Oh, okay, fuck, here's a better one. Okay. The Hubble telescope. I forgot to put in a lens. Read the top line. Alpha Centauri, Sirius, Arrest is just a black hole. I once called Stephen Hawking's house. Hello, this is Stephen Hawking. Yes, I'd like to leave a message. No, this is Stephen Hawking. I know one thing, though. You know, pot is not like alcohol. Alcohol changes your mood sometimes. Like, go to a bar at happy hour and see some just happy motherfuckers there. See those guys going, hey, fuck you, my man. Hey. Hey, listen to me. Listen to me, you piece of shit. Listen, you do not know shit about fuck, my man. You want a piece of yourself? Step outside, I'll kick my ass. Come on. I've already shit myself. I'm halfway there. Come on. Come on, you fucker. And some people know you can deal with it genetically. You know, if you're Irish, you've got a running start, that you can do it better than we are. You know that, because if you're Irish, you know, you'll kick my ass, but then you'll fucking sing about it afterwards. Oh, that night you said my wife was fat. I knocked you down and shit in your hat. Away the time we go, love it. Coming away for air. Moving the time, my lawyer. And then you keep drinking till you're in your 80s and you're on a dialysis machine doing liver dance and Michael Flatline. Beep. And they say the Irish saved civilization, drank a couple of Guinness and forgot where they fucking put it. But that's all right. Here's the drill. And the Japanese, they drink differently than us. It is a different thing where you can be very polite during the day, and all of a sudden you, arigato gozaimasu. And after 5 Jack Daniels, Taiyo Yellow River. And for my karaoke for asshole with a microphone. Sing you round-eyed fuck, come on. And if you want a linguistic adventure, go drinking with a Scotsman. Because you can't fucking understand them before. You land in Scotland and they're going, Till keep any fill, eh? Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, right, you think, eh?
Fuck, take it up, fight, burn the bullets, that's it, right? Pay something you like, eh? Sure. Oh, fuck, sure, eh? Burn your rubber butt backside there, tweak your last little pull of it, eh? Sure. Oh, sure, you dumb fucking bastard. You realize that, eh? And you realize how drunk they get. They could wear a skirt and not care. And how they could invent a sport like golf. Here's my idea for a fucking sport. I knock a ball in a gopher hole.
Oh, you mean like pool?
Fuck off, pool.
That was a straight stick with a little fucked up stick. I whack the ball, it goes in a gopher hole.
Oh, you mean like croquet?
Fuck croquet! I put the hole hundreds of yards away! Oh, fuck off, yeah! It's great fun there! Oh, yeah, that's a great thing!
Oh, like a bowling thing?
Fuck no! Not straight, I put shit in the way! Like trees and bushes and high grass, so you can lose your fucking ball and go whacking away with a fucking tire iron. Whacking away, and each time you miss, you feel like you're gonna have a stroke. Fuck, that's what we'll call it. A stroke, because every time you miss, you feel like you're gonna fucking die. Oh, great. Oh, and here's a better part. Oh, fuck, this is brilliant. Right near the end, I'll put a flat piece with a little flag to give you fucking hope. But then I'll put a pool and a sandbox to fuck with your ball again. Ah, you'll be there trashing your ass, jerking away in the sand.
Oh, you do this one time.
Fuck no! 18 fucking times! Learn! And you have a sport!
The manly sport of golf, where you can dress like a pimp and no one will care. Where you can wear clothes and even a blind gay man would go, oh, dear Christ. Those are loud. This is not carnival. What the fuck are you on? Even the alligator's going, asshole. And you get in the... It's such an exciting athletic sport, too. Whack the ball, get in the cart. Whack the ball, get in the cart. And the commentary's electrifying. Just this side of curling for really getting me going.
We're on the third green now. Could people be quieter? I'd like to hear the grass grow.
I want the guy who does Mexican soccer to do golf one time. The ball is rolling. The ball is going to the...
To see all those old waspy motherfuckers go, oh dear Christ! My God, they're not gardening, they're playing now! Oh shit! What the hell are we gonna do?
Because that was their last domain of dominance. It was their area. They were the king up until Tiger. Yes! Son of a black man and a Thai woman. Not even a German geneticist could have thought that one up. Black athletic ability, Buddhist concentration. Shitai! Kudai! Crouching putter! Ha ha! And then he goes to the British Open and he plays at St. Andrews, where they fucking invented the sport. And after the fourth round, he's 18 under par and there's only 18 fucking holes. And all the old men are going, oh my God, we're doomed! How did he learn to play? We wouldn't let him join. Dear God. And they start having nightmares of golf carts going, yo, 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 I'm playing through. Whether you're a Gentile or a Jew, Pebble Beach, motherfucker. Cindy. Because all of your gentle sports are no longer gentle. Tennis used to be, oh. Until the Williams sisters, ah! 40 love? No, that's good love, baby. Yeah. And boxing, even boxing's changed. Remember boxing? People go, I go to boxing to watch the sport of boxing. Yeah, it's like saying, I go to stock car races to see people take left turns all day. No, you go to boxing to see someone get the fuck beat out of them. Even the guy who loses going, I have $18 million. I don't know where it fucking is. I'm gonna buy me a big ass house, but I can't find it. Fuck off. Until boxing was the same, and then Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson comes along and bites somebody. Let's get ready to nibble. An
And all these guys go, oh, dear God, he bit somebody. I'm saying, you're lucky he just bit somebody. Mike just got out of prison. You're lucky he didn't fuck him. Come on. You bite somebody in jail, it's like, get ready, bitch. You're mine now. Break it up when I'm finished. Because Mike said to a journalist, I'm going to fuck you too. You love me. And at that point, I'm going, someone didn't come here to box, babe. And by, you know, Mike said, I'm on Zoloft, so I don't kill you motherfuckers. I'm going, up the dosage, Mike. But there's all these drugs, Zoloft, Prozac. I want to have one drug encompassing it all. Call it fuck it all. I don't feel anything. I don't want to do anything. Fuck it all. The closest thing to a coma you'll ever be. Fuck it all. I'm sitting here in my own dung. Fuck it all. But the scary thing about drugs like that is they always have some horrible side effect, like may cause artificial insemination. Wow. What? What do you mean? Like there's a product called Olestra, which is a very strange thing. Olestra, what is that? You know, it said on the little side of the chips, it said, may cause anal leakage. Wow. That's not a side effect. If my ass is going... I think that's an effect, really. I think if it's fire in the hole, bad day. If you're going, how you doing, Bob? Oh, just a little anal leakage, Ted. Bob, you want to get out of the pool right now? Because, damn it, I want science to help me. God, look at me. Look at this. My God, I've had women in New York say, don't wear fur. I mean, look at me. The politically correct, so red paint. Fuck off, lady, it's me. I'm a fucking chia pet. Come on. I've gone to the zoo and had monkeys go. And anybody who thinks a zoo is a happy place, go and watch the monkeys wait for groups of school children and watch the fun, because the monkeys just sit there like, wait for it. Wait till the teacher comes with a video camera. Now, yeah! Fire! Yeah! Because they're not happy. Even the poor animals like Ling Ling the panda, she must mate so you could build a wing on the zoo. So they go to China and they anesthetize a panda, which is kind of redundant, and they bring him back to America and give him a name like Ping Pong. Oh, when his Chinese name was Wu Shu Ka He, bear with balls of steel. And they put him in the cage with Ling Ling and say, go mate. And he looks at her like, I would never fuck her. That is one ugly panda bitch. If you were a panda, you would know that's the ugliest fucking panda bitch there is. I would not fuck her with a koala's dick. Fuck off. No, I would rather lick my own balls than fuck that panda bitch. Because there is only one animal who can tell you if she is happy and wants to mate. That is Coco the silverback gorilla. And she saw me, the blue-eyed simian. She was intrigued. She said to her trainer, and I went, what does that mean? She wants you to tickle her. Okay, I tickle her. She's, oh, oh, oh. Okay, then she goes, what does that mean? She wants you to lift your shirt. I lift my shirt. She reaches out and grabs both my nipples. And when an 800-pound gorilla's got you by the tits, you listen. And then a fun thing happened because my balls went, somebody wants to play. Shall we go to phase two? No, do not go to phase two. I repeat, do not go to liftoff. This may feel like a human, but notice the placement of the thumbs. This is not a human. Do not go to phase two. Warning, warning. But she must have sensed something because she grabs me by the hand, starts to take me in the back, and it's like Doctari meets Deliverance. And I'm expecting the crocodile hunter to walk out and go, oh, crikey. She wants to fuck his brains there. Watch out, boys and girls. Danger, danger, danger. This could be like that time I put my finger in a croc's cloaca. Bad, bad news. But part of me went, could be fun.
Make a great story for a bar. Guys are going, I had a wild night in Vegas. Yeah, well, I banged a gorilla. Where's everybody going? And you don't want that late night phone call like, ring, hello?
Don't call me.
And maybe it's because I'm 50. Maybe it's because when you hit 50, the old machinery doesn't work so well. You'll be in a public restroom going, how you doing? Great game today, huh? What's happened is your prostate is bigger than your ego now. Remember the first time it hits you when you're in your 40s, you have to go to the doctor and they have to do the old first time. I say, oh my God, I'm just putting on the glove, Mr. Williams. I went back the second time, I moaned another doctor's name. Don't do that. They get jealous. Who's Dr. Smith? You're the only one. And I appreciate now when a woman has to go to the gynecologist, you don't want a doctor who has a hobby. You don't want a gynecologist who's also a magician. No. You don't want somebody going, how are we today? Oh, a dove. Whoa, what's this? Whoa, 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 whoa. Hold on, is this your card? I don't want a doctor who is a proctologist and ventriloquist. No. I don't want somebody going, how are you doing today? Take your hand out of my ass. I'm not a Muppet. Move it. Because when you go to the doctor in your 50s, it's no longer the... It's the orthoproctoscope. The colonoscopy, that's what W did. Yes, it's a video camera on the end of a roto-rooter. And it's going up you. Suddenly, you're your own Discovery Channel special.
Slowly, we are going up Robin's colon. This must be what you see. Slowly, up ahead, a burger he had in 85.
Oh my God! Is that a polyp?
No, that's a fart, Mr. Williams. Don't be afraid.
And then to go further up your ass, they blow air. Now you're a fucking party favor. It's like, no, Doc, give it to me. Give me all you can take. I'm a man. Give me 120 PSI. Whoa, you feel like a pinata. You think little Mexican kids are going to come out and go, get the presents, get the presents. And I know the air is coming this way. The farts are going, incoming. It's not a... No finger, it's something, it's it. Fall back behind the shit, wait for my command. Prepare to make the wet, sloppy noise. Because the moment they pull that tube out of your ass, you are an Evinrude. Rolling, rolling, rolling. Keep that colon flowing, right. 40 miles blowing out of you. You put on your pants, and you're flowing like a balloon spinnaker in the America's Cup. Coming about, Jimmy, she's yar. And then you realize, oh, shit, fire in the hole. Tighten up, boys, we're not going to drop here. Thank you, doctor. See you next week. Hold the elevator. Fuck you, you bastard. Seven flights of stairs. Everybody you pass, you're going, it's me. Dogs look at you like, roll over, man, you're dead. You just want to borrow a match and go, give me that. Flaming asshole. Go on, because that's what you are. You're a flaming asshole. You're 50. And can they make a drug to help you through all that to keep all of your organs intact till your golden years? No. Can they make a drug to give you mental clarity to your golden time? No. They got a drug to make you harder than Chinese algebra. Grandpa could have wood again.
Oh, God, oh, yeah, wood, yeah, look at it there.
I don't need the walker. I see that. And your grandmother's going, oh, shit, I thought the war was over. God, give me a tetanus shot if you're going to stick me with that rusty fucking thing. Get away. Ah! Ah! died on Viagra, they have to have the open coffin. It's horrible. People walking there going, oh, dear God, I don't remember Pete being like that. Kids, go get some horseshoes. He would have wanted it that way. And it's amazing, too, because you used to have to get that. You had to get for some strange Chinese aphrodisiac like hummingbird eyelash and rhino horn to give you great masculinity. But now, on Viagra, you are back. You are Frankencock. You are the inseminator. You are ready to go. You are going to be going for 1 hour, 1 hour and a half. And a lot of guys are going, yeah. A lot of women are going, uh-uh. Because after the first hour, your wife's going, oh, 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 yay. Oh, big daddy. Oh, whoa. Hoo, ha. Listen, I got shit to do, okay? Oh, okay. Oh, 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 yay. Oh, oh. Ring. Hello. Hey, I'll be late today. Viagra. Fucking. Well, no, I'll try and get there. Oh, go outside with that thing, God. And you can't go outside with a hard-on because the cat just waits for it to go. And your dog's going, whoa, you too? Can't go to work like, hey, Bob, how you, Pete? How you doing? Yeah, I'm happy to be here today. Direct traffic? No, you can't do shit. You have to make it go away, and you're slapping it. It's like one of those little punch-me clowns. Ha, 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 ha. Ha, 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 ha.
I'm not going anywhere.
You have to finish it off. You gotta go, all right, I'll do it, I'll finish it. And in the old days was, but not all. After an hour and a half, you've got more semen than the Fifth Fleet. So when you go, it's like, oh, my eyes. And your wife goes, now you know how it feels, asshole. Pew, boo, oh, boo. Aim for the tits, Hawkeye. Well, oh, my God, I'm like a lawn boy. Get out. Save yourself. Not the drapes, too late. I own that, I own that. No, my God. Oh, well, my. Woo! And you run out of semen and your testicles going, we've still got an erection, Chief. Give me blood, give me urine, any fluid. Boo, gee, God. Oh, well, God. Please make this fucking thing go away. Ah, oh, you do every goofy fucking orgasmic thing. Oh! Fuck! Pee! Don't touch it. Don't look at it. Don't even think about it. And then you realize that God gave you a penis and a brain and only enough blood to run one at a time. You have lost thoughts from your childhood. And then you hear these words from your lady. My turn. You can't fucking be serious. Look at me, I'm Goo Boy. What are you doing? No.
Well, that's right, Corky. It's time to saddle up. We're heading south of the border. You gotta please Missy. And I have one question for the ladies. Do we look like this?
almost there. No, I will finish. No, I love you. I love you. No, I will finish. Look, I said it, I said it. I just can't feel my face. No, who's your daddy? I love you.
One.